Officials at the Ministry of Health say consumption of tobacco products increases the COVID-19 mortality among those who contract the novel virus. According to the Permanent Secretary in the Ministry of Health, Dr. Diana Atrine, those who smoke are being advised to quit in order to save their lives.
Annually, over 8 million people die because of tobacco-related problems. And that is directly. Then over 1 million people die as a result of passive smoking. That is, people are not using tobacco directly, but are in close contact or in close spaces to those who are using tobacco. It is important to know that all forms of tobacco are dangerous.
Amidst the COVID-19 pandemic, it's important for people to stop smoking to keep their lungs in a better condition. Commemorating the World Non-Tobacco Day, a themed Commit to Quit Tobacco, Minister of Health officials warned of the dangers that await the tobacco consumers, especially now when the country is grappling with a deadlier COVID-19 wave.
It is also very important during this time when we are going through a COVID pandemic, facing a surge, the second, to note that with COVID, actually the risk of dying from tobacco-related problems is higher, and also vice versa. Once you're using tobacco, you're at risk of getting more severe form of COVID and actually dying.
Dr. Twine revealed that recent research indicates that places that do not restrict smoking have become breeding areas for the COVID-19 infections.
Imagine people who are smoking shishas. Can they really avoid COVID? Because someone is smoking, is giving another one, is giving another. Now, if there is anyone there who has COVID, everyone who is there, who is smoking, that whole gang will get COVID.
The ministry is now dedicating more efforts to helping those who smoke or chew tobacco to quit the habit.
We're still grappling with the court cases, and we've not been able to go out to the districts. So the different local governments are trying to do what they can do, but for us as centre, we have put in place most of the things that are required to enable us implement this law. What we shall need now is the money that will actually require to go out as we do the enforcement.
The use of tobacco leads to nearly 8 million deaths every year globally, according to the World Health Organization, predominantly due to lung and heart diseases. Out of these, over 7 million deaths are a result of direct tobacco use and the rest due to the exposure to second-hand smoke. About 80% of the deaths occur in low and middle-income countries. Tobacco use, besides being a major risk factor for the disease, cancer, chronic lung disease and diabetes, is also putting people with these conditions at a higher risk of developing severe illnesses when infected by COVID-19. Story by Rachel Nachwala for the news.